Good afternoon. I was supposed to speak in the morning, but since I showed up late, I guess I've been pushed to the afternoon. Thank you. So after the flamboyance of C.P. Gurnani, after the exuberance of Amitabh Kant, you'll hear a very boring speech from me, a written speech actually, so please bear with me. C.P. had mentioned that the last time this room was full for the Global Entrepreneurship Summit, we had Ivanka Trump here. Then came the NASSCOM India Leadership Forum. We had Deepika Padukone here. Now, for the International Blockchain Congress, I've just figured out Abhishek's trick. I think what he did do was either of the two things. Either he told you guys that Katrina Kaif was going to be the showstopper today, or I think he succeeded in convincing all of you on the power, on the ability of blockchain. And so therefore, you have many, many MOUs being signed by many institutions. And I welcome you all once again to the International Congress on Blockchain being held in the wonderful city of Hyderabad. Back in 2014, when we had the opportunity to begin afresh as a new state, when we started our journey, we wanted to create a business-friendly regulatory environment in Telangana. We made the most of our advantage of not having any legacy policies by going back to the drawing board and thinking hard about our strategy to create a bustling economic atmosphere in the state. The approach we took back then, I would say, is quite unique. Unlike other states and countries, we did not opt to go for standard-looking policies in sectors that are mainstream. Instead, we dreamt big. We envisioned the needs of a technology-enabled society a decade or two from now. One of the things our Honorable Chief Minister, Sri K. Chandrasekhar Rao, always reminds us is that any technology which does not have a large-scale societal impact, which is of no value to the society at large, is futile. This led us to adopt a hybrid policy model that focuses not only on traditional sectors, but also places equal or more emphasis on technologies of the future. In 2016, 18 months after thorough research and consultative meetings, we launched the ICT framework, better known as the IT policy of the state of Telangana. The IT policy takes an extensive approach by focusing on 10 areas. The 10 focus areas emphasize on further strengthening Telangana's position as an IT and IT-enabled services destination, while at the same time scaling up our efforts to be the pioneer in new age technologies. One of the main focus areas is completely on emerging technologies such as Internet of Things, smart technologies, AI, machine learning, blockchain, etc. Boosting our efforts on this front, we came out with two dedicated sub-policies for IoT and data analytics towards the end of 2016. As the world is now moving into the fourth industrial revolution, as we all know, India had missed out on the earlier three industrial revolutions. This time, I do believe very confidently that we are not going to miss this digital revolution, which is close to our hearts and in which we have proved our expertise to the world as well. To India and to the state of Telangana, it brings tremendous opportunities to leapfrog many stages of development. Klaus Schwab, Professor Klaus Schwab of World Economic Forum, states that it is a new chapter in human development enabled by extraordinary technological advances which are merging the physical, digital and biological worlds in ways that create both huge promise and potential peril at the same time. We are preparing to seize the opportunities that we are in the process of building our in-house expertise in emerging technologies, fostering partnerships with the industry, and collaborating with innovative startups to drive the new wave of emerging tech-based solutions within the government departments and public-facing projects, and also propelling the entire ecosystem. As per Gartner research, user centricity, agility, and sustainability are driving the technology trends that are transforming governments and the technology trends that would impact governments that typically are artificial intelligence, blockchain, IoT, cloud, VR, AR, robotics, 3D printing, and big data. We have developed a roadmap to assist the various government departments and organizations in identifying specific technology solutions that will address specific challenges or pain points and strengthen service delivery or enhance user experience or improve operational efficiency. As we all know, the transactions made using blockchain are secure and immutable and are stored in a decentralized way that makes systems more transparent and perhaps more democratic as well. The underlying technology makes it a potential candidate for many non-financial purposes. For governments and organizations across the world are exploring various use cases in public sector, healthcare, retail, real estate, insurance, and others. While blockchains per se are not panacea, they could have a substantial impact in many areas, and it is necessary to be prepared for the challenges and opportunities they present. When applied in government processes, blockchain augments the credibility, accuracy, and efficiency of the practices while reducing the risk of fraud. Also, as it is possible to set up permissioned blockchains that enable governments to maintain certain control over the transactions, the technology can be used in various areas such as land records, transportation, managing health records of citizens, voting in elections, peer-to-peer energy transactions, taxation and welfare payments, entitlements, and so on. Maintenance of land records and availability of easily accessible land information is one of the most important issues facing governance today. Citizens simply do not have the confidence in the system the way land records are maintained today in our country. Some people are unsure if they legally own a piece of land, even if they have a legitimate sale deed. Others who want to buy a piece of land are not sure if the seller legally owns it, and sometimes it is found that the same property is being sold to more than one person. Realizing that the use of blockchains for land records would bring in revolutionary changes through inbuilt transparency, traceability, and efficiency in the system, we in Telangana have set out to streamline the system and conceptualize an integrated land record management system to develop a modern, comprehensive, transparent, and near real-time land records in the lines of our core banking solution as envisioned by our Honorable Chief Minister. The project envisages facilitating the department by providing a clear legal title and complete updated information to landowners, tenants, and clarify issues regarding title, possession, claims, and surcharges, etc. But before implementing this solution, we undertook a gigantic exercise of cleansing or purifying the land records that are existing in the system. This exercise was taken up in 10,875 revenue villages in the state of Telangana and in about 568 mandals. During the extensive drive, 93% of the land details were recorded and computerized, and buoyed by this success, we are also planning now to carry this exercise in the urban pockets of Telangana as well. As you've seen today, blockchain technology can also be used to secure critical documents such as educational certificates issued by government agencies, universities that are used for multiple purposes by citizens during their lifetime, and hence there is a critical need to ensure the integrity of such documents. We are initiating pilot projects to secure 10th grade and 10 plus 2 certificates issued to students in the state of Telangana. The certificates transaction data will be stored on blockchain, and the external user agencies such as other universities, banks, financial institutions, government agencies or any private organizations offering employment can verify the data submitted by the students against the data stored in the blockchain records for authenticity and veracity. We're working on several other user cases too, such as blockchain-based solution for the transport department, which would create a robust ecosystem that proactively tracks the entire life cycle of the vehicle from manufacturer to dealer to buyer to seller and to insurance companies as well, all the way from a vehicle manufacturing to the time it gets scrapped. This will obviously have immense benefits to various stakeholders. In addition to this, we've also launched a pilot to track the transactions of chit funds. Chit funds in the state of Telangana are a financial instrument that will also protect the interests of millions of subscribers in our state. We also want to work closely and collaborate with all the stakeholders. And as you have seen, we have signed a couple of MOUs. Significant of them, obviously, is to create a blockchain district in the state of Telangana. And I'm delighted and I'm thankful to CP Gurnani, Tech Mahindra, and to Nucleus, and 1101 is what you call it now? 1101. 1101, and to all the various stakeholders who've taken part in these MOUs. I'm sure as part of this arrangement, this would further strengthen the blockchain ecosystem in the state and will position the state of Telangana as a leading destination for blockchain companies and investors. I see the International Blockchain Congress as a significant milestone in our efforts, in our journey, and I wish you all a very fruitful 2 days of networking, knowledge sharing and fun. I know the third day of this event is happening in Goa. Amay, we are not joining you in Goa, but I'm sure you'll have a lot of fun in Goa. We all know you guys actually love to have fun. So while you're here in Hyderabad, enjoy our biryani, enjoy pearl shopping, enjoy looking at our exquisite handlooms, and enjoy the comforts that this wonderful city of Hyderabad offers. Good luck. God bless.